Well, hello, everybody. My name is Mike Rosen. I want to welcome you all to our virtual 2021 Quality Improvement Summit. Obviously, I wish we could all be doing this in person this year, but as we get into the tail end of COVID, that's just not been possible. But hopefully next year, we'll be able to do this in person. But regardless, I think you guys are in for a great session today. I think we have a lot of exciting, impactful talks that are really going to change your practice. On behalf of the entire QC and myself and Ben, we look forward to a great session today. And again, thank you all for being a part of this. And I just want to specifically point out all of our stakeholders. I can't stress enough that we could not do this without everybody on this list. You all have a special role in this. And I hope you all take the same pride that I do in looking at what we've accomplished and how far we are actually moving the dial in hernia surgery and abdominal cord health. I also just want to take a second and specifically recognize our foundation partners. We could not do this without your support. I realize this year with COVID has been particularly tough for everybody, including industry. And again, I want to thank you all for this. I hope you share in the pride that I do in looking at today of how far we've moved hernia surgery and where we can actually go through this type of collaboration. So just briefly, I think it's important sometimes for everybody to step back and look 8 years later at actually what we have accomplished. We have over 450 surgeons who are involved now throughout the entire United States. We're actually in almost all 50 states. And I think one of the things that I am most excited about is we represent fairly close to the real world in hernia surgery, where we have about 50% academic and 50% private practice and community affiliated surgeons. And I think as you see in the talks today, you will actually be able to appreciate that that is about the ratio in our talks. And really that shows the contribution and the fact that everybody does have an important voice in this collaborative. Again, we surpassed a huge milestone. This month, we have over 75,000 patients in the ACHQC now, which is just really a tremendous effort over the past 8 years. We still are about two-thirds ventral hernias, but inguinal hernias are rapidly increasing. It's certainly a more common operation, particularly done in the community setting. I also want to just stress this year, we've had the addition of seven key ACHQC committees. Please take a second and think of any of these, including our data integration to streamline surgeon end of data by Clayton Petro and Jeremy Warren, our research committee looking to design all of our clinical trials by Richard Pierce. If you have any residents and fellows that would like to get involved, I think this is a huge first step in joining the collaborative early and seeing the benefit. Again, one of the most exciting groups that we have is our patient engagement and advocacy committee led by Harriet Schwartzman and Eric Beauford. And again, some of those patients are on the call today. So thank you very much for all that you've done. Our quality improvement committee led by Ragnar Peterson that has been instrumental in coming up with some of the topics today. And then our membership and surgeon outreach committee that has been led by Todd Harris and David Carpata. They will start off the next section. And again, they put a tremendous amount of work into trying to understand what our surgeons' needs are and how to make things better. And then Mickey Reinhorn, who's led the opioid task force, that has just done tremendous work that has really personally changed my practice tremendously. So just briefly, the agenda today, we're going to start off with the data input and utilization optimization. We're going to hear from different practice groups and how they've been able to optimize entering data into the collaborative. I will tell you that this is probably the most common question that I get when people start out is how do I incorporate this into my practice? And we're going to really learn from some of our high performers. And then we're going to move on and learn from our high performers, and specifically inguinal hernia approaches and ventral incisional and peristomals. I think this is actually the most exciting aspect of the QC, because here we are actually identifying people who really do these procedures in a high volume. And this doesn't necessarily mean the folks who write the most papers or whatnot. These are the people who really do this. And I think this is the most impactful thing when we did this before. So I really look forward to hearing some great talks around this as well. Again, one of the things that makes the collaborative important, in particular our QI summit, is engagement. So please engage in the discussion. I realize this is virtual and it can be a little bit more challenging, But use the chat rooms that you can ask questions. The moderators will be looking at those and they will bring those up during the panel sessions. I think that will make things flow the best way through this in a virtual way to move through each of the talks and sessions and get the most of your questions answered. We'll also have a poll opportunity that we have some pre-done polls that you can click on your keyboard and answer those and we'll see the results. And we'll give you an example of that just at the end of my talk here. So just kind of to summarize, my goal for today is to make an impact in your practice. I think this is not like coming to a regular meeting. This is your data. And let's see if you can use your data to actually alter your practice. And again, I want to be clear, my challenge to each of you is at the end of today, think about the three things that you are going to do differently on Monday based on the lectures that you have heard, and then we can still continue on to measure things. And most importantly, at the end of today, because we are a core health organization, we are going to have a fun Peloton ride. You will be given a different Zoom to join if you want to watch that. Also, we'll share with you the ride that we're all going to jump on. Again, this can be for fun. It can be competitive. It can be whatever you want. But again, that's really, to me, what the key of this collaborative is. So again, thank you to each of you. And I look forward to a great session today.